Signum Portugalia was created in 2014. At first, it aimed only at inventorying and cataloging and digitizing the medieval seals of Portuguese secular clergy. This particular universe was chosen as it was then my main research field, as well as the one of the colleague with whom I created the project. But we always ambitioned to widen the corpus to the whole universe of Portuguese seals up to the end of the ancient regime, and in the case of royal seals, up to 1910, the year when the monarchy ended in Portugal. This first project, or better said, this first phase of the global project was hosted by the Center for Religious History Studies, a research unit of the Portuguese Catholic University in Lisbon, to which we were both connected. The project received funding from the Carlos Gulbenkian Foundation, who had at the time a program of support to the recovery, treatment, and organization of archive collections. The reasons for creating this project were simple: the lack of catalogs and inventories of seals in Portugal. As a matter of fact, sigillographic studies have had a late development in Portugal. Contrary to many other European countries, there was no catalogue of seals in any archive or library, and no casting campaign was ever carried out. The main work on Portuguese sigillography had been for decades the one of the Marquis of Abrantes, published in 1983, that surely some of you have already seen. And which is often confused with a real catalogue of Portuguese seals, despite only focusing on a small part of non-royal seals preserved in some archives and including a group of mattresses belonging to private owners. This work, though undoubtedly of great value, presents many inaccuracies and does not comply with international inventorying and cataloging standards defined since 1990 by the International Vocabulary of Sigillography. Furthermore, there was no systematic survey giving an account of the number of seals or their condition, or allowing to know the losses incurred. The analysis I carried out for my PhD at the seals prior to 1319 from the archives of the Cathedral Chapter of Coimbra, stored at the National Archives, pointed to almost 50% of missing seals, only 25% of the remaining being in good condition. And given that this is one of the most important Portuguese funds containing seals, such numbers were an alarming indicator of the urgent need to safeguard sigillographic heritage still existing in our country. The results of the project confirmed these figures, as you can see by these charts. This first chart shows the existing, non-existing, and mentioned seals. And as you see, the no longer existing seals are 56%. In this new chart, can see the seals condition concerning their material integrity, only 26% of them are intact. And in the chart on the right side of the slide, you see the seals, also the seals conditions, but in what concerns the preservation of the engraved images, and only 2% can be considered excellent and 20% good. 32% fair, that makes in between fair and excellent only 52% too. So this situation clearly demonstrates the urgency of protecting the Portuguese sigillographic heritage, a protection that necessarily implies its study, because one cannot protect what one does not know that exists or where it can be found. With the funding received from the Gulbenkian Foundation, we were able to develop our database and to search in the custodial institutions chosen to be our partners. You see their logos, mostly archives, both national and district archives, dependent from the general management of archives and libraries in Portugal, but also the National Library and museums from the National Network of Museums, where we were certain to find a significant number of medieval seals from the secular clergy. We add to that two archives connected to the universities, Coimbra and Braga, and also two municipal archives, very important ones like Guimarães and Porto, and two ecclesiastical archives, because in Lisbon and in Évora cathedrals there are still medieval documents in place. So we used for free the collections inventory and management system Index Reru, created by FCO, full service company in multimedia, a Portuguese company developing heritage communication and multimedia solutions, particularly content creation production. You can see here an example of a file, and in the next slide, an overview of some thumbnail pictures of the seals that can tell you something about the condition of preservation of these seals. Main goals of our project were inventorying, cataloging, and digitizing Portugal medieval ecclesiastic seals, treating, organizing, and repackaging the seals and the documents they are attached to, evaluating the number and condition of this sigillographic corpus, providing each custodial institution with a catalogue of their seal collection, including recommendations on preservation and restoration interventions needed, making the digital catalogue available online with open access, and finally, promoting and disseminating the project, not only to a specialised public, but also to civil society. Of course, we are not able to achieve all of our purposes during the approximately year and a half of financing. As so often happens when you start researching on a new area, the project, although limited to a specific universe, proved to be much too ambitious. But it was impossible to have an accurate estimation of what we were going to find, because in the great majority of cases, there were no research guides, no catalogs or inventories, and the few available didn't mention the existence of seals, much less their identification. So this meant we needed to research the complete funds without even knowing how many charters they included. And sometimes reality was completely different from what we expected. At the National Library, for instance, we found several hundred charters which weren't mentioned in the loose parchment inventory, as they had been recently discovered. Thus, this collection did not give us data about only a few dozen seals, as we expected, but about almost 100. There were also unforeseen events regarding the team, which disturbed the smooth progress of the project. One of them was a very happy one. I had my second child, and my capacity of work was, of course, affected, and still is. Another unforeseen event was, though very unpleasant, the resignation by the main researcher who had created this project with me, and was supposed to be working full-time, but in fact never was, for several reasons, including some serious health issues. And in addition to the delays this situation caused, it also obliged us to add new elements to our very small team, who did their best to achieve our goals, but they needed time to learn and adjust to working with seals, which they had never done that before. We also had some unpleasant surprises concerning the custodial institutions, namely, sadly, the Portuguese National Archives, that houses the largest number of Portuguese medieval archival funds, incorporated after the extinction of religious orders in the 19th century, and then after the establishment of the Republican regime in 1910. Although we tried from the first moment to establish a cooperation agreement with National Archives, it was not possible to reach it. We weren't allowed to research all the sealed charters, regardless of their condition, an exceptional authorization justified by the systematic survey we needed to perform, not only for the database, but also in order to elaborate reports on conservation of seals. It was also important to reach an agreement regarding the photographic reproductions for the database, which they wanted us to pay, and to pay expensive fees. So last year, a new law was approved that were in the parliament that allows researchers to take photos in archives and libraries, which I hope will allow us to overcome this rather awkward situation. For all these reasons, it was not possible to finish the research within the project's duration. Research in some archives and libraries has not been completed, and we still need to carry out the study of seals and seal matrices in collections of museums, palaces, and monuments. Despite these constraints, the more than 2,000 records inserted in the database at the time and the hundreds of data that have been added since the end of the funding clearly prove both the importance and the value of research done and the urgency to carry out this project to its next phases. The experience has shown us that dividing the universe of seals to be studied made sense at first, but it would be forcing us to return to the same archival funds several times to inventory the seals that did not belong to the universe we were studying. So I decided to extend the research to the whole of Portuguese seals. And during these last 4 years, I have been enriching the database. It's not public yet, but I've been enriching it with royal, monastic, and private seals kept in all archives and libraries in Portugal or of Portuguese seals kept abroad. And I can show you a very beautiful case, a very beautiful seal, a Portuguese bishop that is kept in the Municipal Archives of Strasbourg in France, and which is catalogued by Sigilla. So the need of linking our databases is very, very well illustrated by this example, I think. But without a real funding and a properly prepared team, it is very difficult to make a project of this magnitude really move forward. I have already participated in several applications for European funding for international sigillographic projects, which unfortunately weren't accepted. And one of them was last year in the company of several speakers in this meeting. While remaining, of course, very interested in being part of an international project, I am trying to develop a smaller one at a national level, centered on the seals existing in the University of Coimbra, in the University of Coimbra's archives and libraries, and in including seals in the conservation and restoration department dedicated to documents and manuscripts that is going to be created at my university. Hopefully, it will finally be possible to organize a course on seals conservation and restoration that we intended to carry out in 2015, but the funding received could not cover. However, these ideas had to be put aside because of pandemics, and they can only be fulfilled in a post-pandemic era that hopefully will come soon. And a project such as this needs time. A precious asset that, in my opinion and from my experience, university professors have less and less. All these obstacles do not take away my enthusiasm and my commitment to this project, I must say. Seals, their study, safeguard, and preservation have become to me not only a topic of my research, but the real cause that is very dear to me. It may take some years, but the goals we thought about 6 years ago, maybe naively, because we thought we could do much more than we could, but these goals will be fulfilled, I'm sure, in a short or medium term future. Thank you very much for your attention.